misconception is, I would say, we are determined, predetermined. My life, my money, my richness, my family, my health, my debt.
Everything
and,
is.
And this was a very famous Indian teacher. Makaligosala's prime philosophy. So we are determined, predetermined. How do we understand? If we are determined, then what's the purpose of virya, effort, energy, virya, effort, samavayama? So how do we sort of
the Buddha says,
attack this misconception?
The Buddha says that if we accept this kind of everything is the result of past karma, everything is already predetermined. If we do that, there is no motivation to follow the moral path. Motivation to improve ourselves because it has been determined. Now, Makaligosala was saying that 84,000 eons or something. It's like taking a ball of twine and throwing it, and until it ends, we just go on through samsara until it ends. Okay, but the Buddha says if that is so, there is no meaning. But if we accept that we can end it, we can end this samsaric cycle, we can end this karma, cause and effect, it is in our power. How it started, anamatagya. Mm-hmm. How it started, we don't know. Mm-hmm. We cannot know. That's important to notice that. We cannot know, given our limited puttujana mind. But given that we cannot know, we should not stop there. We should start applying right understanding. Begin somewhere. And where do we begin? Four Noble Truths. Dukkha, Samudaya, Nirodha, Magga. And in the Magga, you have right understanding. And right understanding means that is our goal. That is where we need
Samadhi.
To be. Yeah, at the moment, we don't have it. Alright? But when it becomes samadhi, then this is the task that the Buddha has given us. You want to free yourself? This is it. Don't say it is somebody else is responsible. It is not fated as such. I created that fate. Which explains why so many different human beings, all 7 billion of us, each is different.
So the word fate is connected to determinism too.
Yes.
So then we are not determined. All right. So now, folks, we have a good news to bring you. The good news is the last misconception that we're going to unpack here. It's that people have a belief that we have to go through all the karmas. Can we do something to mitigate, neutralize some karmas? I wanted to say that there are six heinous karmas, very bad karmas, killing your mom, killing your dad, wounding the Buddha, killing an arahant, and then making conflict among the Sangha, and then believing a teacher who does not teach how to end dukkha.